The men's giant slalom would provide one of the finest runs of the alpine skiing competitions so far, one of the finest comebacks, and one of the most frustrating mistakes. After overnight snow, it all took place in glorious conditions at the Rosakuta Alpine Centre. Starting the event was Alexis Pantourault. It's the 22-year-old's first Olympic Winter Games. He failed to finish in the Super Combined. But the Frenchman began this event in more promising fashion. This time would be good enough for sixth position at the halfway stage. But this is the man who would take the first run by storm. Ted Ligety is renowned as a giant slalom expert and was an Olympic champion 8 years ago in the combined. In this most competitive field, nobody would come close to the American's time. It was arguably the finest performance of the alpine skiing events so far. Now to Steve Missilier, the 29-year-old who serves in the French Army. He wasn't considered among the leading contenders for a medal. Missilier would end this run in 10th position, but only 2/10 of a second behind the top three. This is the man who should have been in second place after the opening run. Stefan Lutz of Germany, only 21 years of age, had been closer to Ligety's split times than anyone else. But something unexpected was about to occur. German ski goes the wrong side of the gate, which means Lutz will be disqualified. So the standings after the opening run show Ligety's lead is nearly a full second ahead of Ondřej Bank of the Czech Republic. The second run would prove trickier for many of the athletes.
5, 4.
Norway's Kjetil Jansrud, champion in the Super-G, was hoping to improve on his 15th position from the first run. And his split times were encouraging until this happened. It was almost within sight of the finish. So to Missilier, starting the second run 10th. Knowing it would take something special to overtake so many good skiers, he attacked from the start and kept it going. Missilier would be the fastest man on the second run. There was only one minor slip from which he soon recovered. Pantourault was hoping to give French supporters even more to cheer. He was sixth after the first run, but within touching distance of the medal placings. He couldn't match Missilier's time over the top part of the course, and the steep sections were getting rougher all the time. Still, Pantourault moved into second place. He'd also survived an anxious moment. Missilier was still the leader, and soon only two racers were left to go. Ondřej Bank was the first of those, second after the opening run and hoping for the best result of his life. But the course was proving ever more difficult, and Bank wasn't as precise as he needed to be. Both Frenchmen were now guaranteed a medal. But with Ligeti's advantage so great from the first run, surely neither would get the goal. The American began with a huge advantage of 1.5 seconds over Missilier. But that advantage started to slip away. There were some nervous moments. But Ligeti's outstanding first run meant he still had time in hand. The Olympic title in the giant slalom was his. For a fraction of a second, Ligeti's skis were both pointing back up the mountain. But he stayed on track for the gold medal. So here's the official result from the men's giant slalom. It's a second Olympic title for Ligeti, but his first since Torino in 2006. Missilier and Panturo make it a day to celebrate for France. But spare a thought for Marcel Hirscher. The Austrian who was fourth in this event in Vancouver is fourth again.
Ted Ligeti!
So it's Ted Ligeti in his favourite event who wins the title in the giant slalom.